I want to ask the two powerhouses behind this partnership, how did Game Change come to be? And I'll start with you, but I want you to go back and forth and share your thoughts. Yes.
Hello.
We'll start with our attorney.
Well, last spring, I was speaking at a Boston Chamber of Commerce event, and I was speaking about a whole bunch of subjects. When I stepped down, though, from the podium, I was asked about the matter of Deflategate and the NFL. And my comment that I made at the time was that the NFL had its priorities out of line, and that they should be focusing on issues of domestic violence and sexual assault, and not wasting time. Of this matter. So we care about domestic violence, we care about sexual assault, it's a priority in the office, but that was a comment I just sort of made, and sometimes it's just great when the right people are listening, because that led to a call from Robert Kraft, and then we ended up getting together, and that was great.
So you hear her comment, and you think, what?
First of all, I really like strong women, and I don't think anyone would fault me for that, but especially strong, intelligent women. And did you say what your comment was exactly on, what she said was she thought what happened with Brady, I mean she said the second part, but this part about Brady.
It was ridiculous.
For him to be suspended for 4 games and a gentleman for the Ravens to be suspended for 2 games and they had no proof. Smart, strong woman. So we used that as an opportunity to get together and have a chat up. And, you know, I knew that we have someone on our staff who was a captain at Harvard basketball, and she told me about Moore and how outstanding, you know, I love dealing with people who are high school or college athletes because they learn how to compete and sometimes even learn how to lose, and when they lose they don't like it. They come back harder, and I heard a lot about Moore there. I started thinking, well, in our philanthropic giving, we try to do things where we can make a difference, where people aren't stepping in. Either it's unpopular or they don't want to deal with it. And those are the things that really turn our family on. And life is about having great partners at whatever you do, whether it's business, philanthropy, sports, teams. Need good people around you. And after meeting Mara and her team, I thought how great it would be if we could work this problem together. And, you know, seeing her leadership and working with MVP, with Dan and Deborah, and then listening, I mean, talk about courageous woman. For you to get up here and say that and to press charges, I just hope our D-line is as tough as you. It's really then listening to Otto, who's played, and seeing him come up. And that's what Moore and I talked about. Having, you're giving us psychic income of seeing the results of what all of you are being trained and trying to do.
You know, these abusive relationships have gone on forever, and as you're deciding, yes, this is what we're going to take on, this is our priority, how did you decide to start with high school students?
Well, you know, I think in our line of work, too often we're seeing people on the back end of these experiences once they're involved in a criminal justice system, when we're working through our office and trying to provide support to victims and survivors. And I think that what appealed to both of us was this idea of how can we attack it at its root There's no better way to do that than through earlier intervention in education. And so I think we both had a lot of will, but we surrounded ourselves with people who could help point the way. And ultimately, this was about execution. And I just echo Robert's comments and compliments to Northeastern, the Center for Sports Society, the Mentors in Violence Prevention Program, to Jane Doe, Deborah, all of the many agencies that work on issues of combating domestic violence and sexual assault, and certainly our partners out there, and all of you who've now been through the program. But I think that, you know, the earlier we can get to people to empower young people, maybe we should even start before high school, but we thought high school was a good place to start, to give them the tools to recognize the signs of bullying, of stalking, of dating violence, of unhealthy relationships, and then give them the tools to respond and react appropriately. This is about addressing issues before they grow worse, and giving young people the tools that they need to build and grow into healthy relationships and dynamics.
And you both felt a certain, for lack of a better word, obligation to address this at this level. I mean, you both are very driven and results-oriented, and yet this is something for which you can't see an immediate payoff, although today is pretty extraordinary. As this progresses, how do you judge the success of Game Change?
Well, probably it'll be hard. I don't know if we have statistics. And one of the things when Mara and I chatted that just overwhelmed me is how ignorant I was as to how deep this problem was in society. I mean, 1 in 3 people are going to experience this. 2/3, I think Tip said, 2/3 of the people don't even report it. And I'm thinking, you know, I have a couple granddaughters, even though I think I'm 35. I have a couple granddaughters in college. And I'm just thinking, and I don't understand how this has not gotten the attention it deserves. You know, part of it is, excuse me for speaking about some of your colleagues in political life. Everything's, or it's like Wall Street, where you do things for quick, short-term benefit. But this is a deep problem. And one of the reasons I love what Mark said to me is let's get to the root of it. And, you know, we're at high school. We probably should be going a level down in school and doing training lower and watching. I came from, I had all sons, so I really was ignorant. I'm just telling you, and it's shocking to me, and it's deep-seated in the country, and we have to grab it and get a hold of it and keep pushing it and doing a better job, because it's just not, in a country, we're in the greatest country in the world, we just can't allow this to keep happening.
And because he's too humble, I will say this, Lisa. You know, this is a subject that is not unfamiliar or concern unfamiliar to Robert or to the Kraft family. And for a long time now, they have supported agencies, efforts, organizations directed at preventing, combating sexual assault and domestic violence. So he's already, and the family and the foundation have already been committed to this effort. This was just an opportunity, if you will, to sort of take it to a different level. And I think you actually can measure success. You look out at this room, you look at the number of folks who have been through the program, it's amazing. In less than a year, where is our favorite? Where is Andre? We started out in Springfield, remember? We did our first event out there, and it's just been school after school, 90 schools already in the state, and in fact, we were oversubscribed. There's a huge amount of interest. I hear from agencies and organizations all the time. I've heard from fellow attorneys generals, actually, who want to try to think about how to replicate their program in their state. So that's success. And I think in time, we will see here in Massachusetts, young people who grow up with a better and healthier respect for the dignity, the value in each of us, And, you know, the wherewithal to actually do what you need to do at an age that can be awkward and uncomfortable, to step up and to do the right thing. And that's awesome. That's what it's all about. And I see that just within a year's time, we've already seen results. We have more to do.
We have to make this cool, that the people caring about it and working on it, that it's the right thing. I mean, once again, I think so much of it has been under the rug and just hasn't been out there for people to see, that we need a lot of mentoring and education and listening to your chat. And I'm just thinking, how many other gals have gone through it, and maybe there haven't been the resources or the avenues for them to connect and do something about it, and they're in prison, and that's not right.
And I think that speaks to what the problem was for Kristen. People look the other way, and with Game Change, this is creating a culture in which nobody looks the other way. They're directly involved in making sure that that kind of abuse, that kind of denigration doesn't happen.
But, you know, let me just pick up on that for a minute. When I was listening to you chat, I'm thinking, and he was a pretty cool guy when you met him and everything. So it started younger. This is in high school. So we really had to bring it down. And unfortunately, maybe some kids aren't getting the right mentoring at home or whatever. And we have to find a way to fill that gap. And all of you as trainers and understanding that, and how we get it down to the next level, because this is much too impactful and negative to society to let it happen, and to have the right kind of family loves. It's got to impact so much more than I understood, and actually the productivity of society to have everyone have a quality life.
You know, I feel like I've been so looking forward to this experience today, because it's just been a week of horrible news, both on a national scale and even locally, and sort of be in a room with people who are committed to changing the culture and making a difference is really uplifting. But I don't think we can not talk about Orlando, because within 24 hours, the killer's ex-wife was saying, "My family had to pry me from his arms." This was someone who was an abuser. I'm just curious, particularly given your commitment to eradicating this terrible problem, how you felt when you heard the news and then heard more about what was behind, sort of, if you will, his evil?
Well, you know, I know Saturday afternoon I marched in the Pride Parade here in Boston. It's Pride Month, a celebration of equality, and a great time within the LGBT community to celebrate and mark some of the gains made. And to wake up Sunday morning to this news, this horrific news, was just so heartbreaking for me as a member of the community, for so many. And, you know, unfortunately, it's just another instance that we have seen of this mass shooting style atrocity. You know, I think that we have a ways to go in this country. Obviously, when it comes to, and you hear some of the rhetoric these days, it's not what it should be. Hate, prejudice, bias, we've got work to do. But I think working from within, and that's what this is about. We recognize, Otto, your show right now, you're not going to listen to the likes of us. But you'll listen to
yourself.
But students, peers will listen to peers, and teaching them new ways and teaching them about what is cool and isn't cool is what it's about. And we need to do that on issues of hate and intolerance. That's when we're our best selves. That's when we've evolved as a country. That's where we need to be. I also think we need to get real, though, about the presence of certain weapons that are accessible to civilians. And I do say, you know, as a matter of law enforcement, that we must make changes there and get back to a place where certain military assault-style rifles and weapons, I distinguish between guns and weapons, these were designed for military use, are simply not available for purchase by civilians, not available in our neighborhoods and our communities. That's something I'm committed to working with anyone and everyone across this country.
You're going to be intensely focused on this even for the next few days. you have this audience here ready to take the next step, and maybe even to your point of starting younger, maybe you have a room full of peer counselors or peer trainers at some point. What is the message you want these young men and women to leave with today?
Well, we're about winning. You know, you win by being able to get along with all kinds of people. When you come and see our football team or our soccer team, and there's so many different nationalities, and people speak different languages, and their lifestyles are different. And when you really want to win, it's about respect and listening and trying to empathize with the people on the other side. And the people who do that the best are the people who are going to win and win continuously. So what happened in Orlando is just so sad. It's Sandy Hook and same situation. And I got to tell you, Ed, I don't understand why any human being in this country needs an assault rifle. To get out there and do that and not just satisfy quirky endorsements. And actually we're lacking that in this country to a great degree, and it's very sad. And for all of you young people in here, the fact that you're doing this and trying to do something that can just have unlimited good in the future is great. And I really thank you for it. And this is a turn on for me to see you all here and see that you care about it and listening, putting things on the table that are very uncomfortable. But if we can solve it and we can make it better, and if we do that, everyone's going to benefit.
Well, I can't improve on that. I will add, though, that, you know, I think for young people and those who work with young people, take back with you an understanding that this is an amazing state with amazing opportunity and the power of partnership. I think one of the things that excited us was how we could put the different pieces together into this program that became game change. And you all need to know that. You got a lot of support out there. People want to see you succeed. They want to see your younger brothers succeed and sisters succeed. And so we are here for you, but we are also really counting on you. We are looking to you, recognizing the signs of stalking, recognizing the signs of sexual assault, recognizing, yes, the signs of domestic violence or an unhealthy relationship, and then being willing to take that on. So, you know, that is our message. We've got your back, you've got all the support in the world, but really, the success of this program ultimately is gonna rest on your shoulders, but we know you're up to it.
Well, thank you for helping us.